Welcome back, band family. Let's begin by reviewing what we worked on last time because it's a great way to warm up our faces. We'll start out by double checking to make sure that we're sitting correctly. Edge of the chair, sitting tall, left foot flat, right foot back. And then double check your M face. You should have with you a mouthpiece and a mirror. So we'll use the mirror to make sure that we have that correct M face. Next up, let's do our air to sound exercise. This is where we blow air through the mouthpiece and then lightly touch the lips together halfway through to produce that sound. You'll notice that I kept my head stable, my chin up, and I brought the instrument up and in, out, and then down. That's exactly the way we play trombone. We want to make sure that we are bringing the instrument to us rather than us going to the instrument. We play the trombone, it doesn't play us. Next up, let's try our next exercise, which is instant sound or instant buzz. It's exactly like air to sound, except that instead of blowing air and then touching our lips together, we'll start from the very beginning by blowing and keeping our lips lightly touching to produce that buzz sound right away. In our last lesson, we talked about a common mistake the beginners make, which is to let their cheeks puff out. And fixing that is also a great way to discover a set of muscles in our face. We fix the cheeks puffing out by firming up our corners using our corner muscles, the muscles at the corners of our mouths. So let's do that again. Incorrectly allow our cheeks to puff out, but then fix it by firming up our corners, because this is a great way to help us isolate where those corner muscles are. Those are going to be helpful in our next exercise after this. By the way, when you bring your cheeks in, it's using our muscles, right? We're using our muscles to bring the cheeks in. Don't try to like suck in air to bring your cheeks in, because you can't play a trombone and produce that buzz sound if you're sucking in air. We're always blowing. We bring the cheeks in with our muscles, not by sucking in. So you'll notice that as I firmed up my corners and brought my cheeks in, the pitch changed as well. The note became higher in pitch, and that's because I firmed up my corners. When we use firm corners, we get higher notes. So let's try some high jets and low jets, which is basically the same thing as instant sound, except we're going to really focus on being able to produce high notes for the high jets and low notes for the low jets. Also be thinking about what a jet airplane would sound like. We want to make sure that it's going very, very steady and even, not going up and down and not stopping and starting, because again, jets should not have their engines stop in mid-flight. That would be bad. Let's try a high jet. Firm corners, that's going to help. The other thing we can do is use our tongue voicing. We talked about this in our last lesson, where changing the shape of our tongue or position of our tongue can change the note. If we were saying E, our tongue is up higher and we get a higher note. If our tongue is down lower, as if we were saying ah, then we'll get a lower note. So to get a high jet, firm the corners and think T as we blow. Now let's try a low jet. Again, we're going to keep it very steady, very even, without it going up and down. But to get a low note, we're going to relax the corners and think about dropping the tongue as if you're saying ah. For trombone players especially, it's really good to kind of have that openness inside your mouth and inside your throat. So you can even think about dropping the jaw down and think ta to help you get those low notes. Just make sure you don't drop the jaw so low that your lips separate, because if your lips separate, well, then you just get air. And our final exercise today will be our dropping bomb exercise. This is where we basically go from a high jet to a low jet without stopping in between. So start out by thinking of your corners being firm and thinking T with the tongue, and then relax the corners and drop the tongue down, and we'll go from high to low. T-ya. Let's give it a shot. I'm going to add an explosion sound at the end. You can feel free to do so if you'd like as well. So I encourage you to do these exercises every day, doing the air to sound, instant sound, high jets, low jets, dropping bombs. They are a great way to improve your strength of your face, improve your endurance, and just get better at playing trombone. Let's move on to assembling our trombone. Go ahead and take your case, lay it on the ground in front of you, and put it so that the handle is on the bottom, facing you. Generally, the lid is not where the handle is, so the handle is on the bottom part of the trombone case. The lid is above that. For most trombone cases, the bell will be to your left, the bigger end, but some are different. There are three main parts to the trombone, the slide, the bell, and the mouthpiece. We already have the mouthpiece sound, but I'm going to have you place it back in the case because I want you to do this in the correct order so that you don't accidentally damage it or drop it. And really, all the instructions I'm giving you today are to help you avoid damaging your instrument. We'll start by taking our right hand and picking up the slide of the instrument. I want you to hold it by these two crossbars like this. Thumb on top, fingers on the bottom. Go ahead and pick that up out of the case and stand up with it. As you do it, I would like you to take the end of the slide that has this water key and make sure it's pointed downward and have it right next to your leg. If you find that this water key is farther away from you, opposite of your leg, you've got it backwards. Make sure that the water key is next to your leg. Another way to do this is to think about the tall and short parts of that trombone slide. You want the tall part to be closest to you and the small part to be away from you. As you look at that slide, since we know that there is a short part and a tall part, a small part and a big part, we want to match up the size of the parts to this. So if we have in the case right now, if we have a small mouthpiece and a large bell, what do you think is going to go in the small part of the slide? Yeah, the small part that's still in the case, the mouthpiece. So go ahead and pick up the mouthpiece, and small goes to small. Put the mouthpiece in the shortest of the two tubes coming out of the slide. As you push that in there, I want you to give it a slight twist as you push. I'll show you how much I'm twisting. I'm going to hold my trombone sideways. You still hold it straight up and down, but I'll show you to get a better angle. You'll put the trombone mouthpiece in and then give it a push and a twist. I twisted it about that much. By giving it a slight twist as I pushed, it helps keep that mouthpiece in position, less likely for it to fall out. Now we have the tall part of the slide and we have the biggest part left in the case, which is the bell. So let's go ahead and grab the bell by taking our left hand, palm down, and grabbing the bell near where it starts to get big. Just like this. And then hold it so that the bell is pointed downward. Now take that trombone bell and place it right on the trombone slide. The angle should be a 90 degree angle, a right angle. So the trombone slide is this way, and the trombone bell is this way. Once it's on there, all the weight is now held in my right hand. This is not yet attached, so I want to be careful that I don't maneuver this trombone around so it would fall off, but the weight of it will keep it in place. I'm going to let go of my left hand, and then I'm going to grab this ring here with the grooves on it, the knurling on it, and I'm going to tighten that ring. I'm going to have to tighten it quite a bit to make sure that it doesn't come loose. If I don't tighten it enough, then the top part of the trombone, the bell, will start to flop over. Remember, I want to make sure that it's at a 90 degree angle, right? So I want to tighten this enough that it's not going to come loose on me. Once I've done that, my trombone is now assembled. We're not going to use the slide today, but it's important for safety reasons for me to tell you about it. There is a little ring here on the slide that if I were to loosen that, the slide would come loose. I want to make sure that I keep that locked into place. We call this a slide lock. So keep that slide lock engaged so the slide won't go anywhere. Now my trombone's fully assembled. It is shaped like an L here from the bell to the slide. And it's nice and tight, and I'm ready to start holding it the correct way. At the end of your practice session, when you disassemble the instrument, you're going to reverse the steps. You're going to transfer the instrument back to your right hand because we hold the instrument on our right hand for assembly or disassembly, but we hold it in our left hand to actually play. So to disassemble, hold this in your right hand. Remember, our right hand grabs the slide just like this. Use your left hand to loosen up that ring, that grooved ring, that knurled ring. When you grab the bell, in order for it to go back in the case correctly, your left palm is going to face in like this. You might need to twist that bell section just a little bit to get it to release, pull up, and set this back inside the case. Then take your left hand, loosen up the mouthpiece, place it back in the case as well. Finally, you can put the slide back in the case. Transfer the instrument back to your right hand. Use your left hand to loosen up that ring. Twist that bell section just a little bit, pull up, and set this back inside the case. Then take your left hand, loosen up the mouthpiece, place it back in the case as well. Now, depending on what kind of case you have, be careful of the position of this water key at the end. It's a delicate mechanism. And some cases have a pocket where you sit it inside, and this part should be sticking up. If it lays flat in the case, same thing. This should be up, facing up. Make sure this doesn't get jammed down inside of your case, depending on how it's built. But figure out how to put it back in just the way you found it. There are probably some different latches to hold the different sections in place. Once it's all in there, close the top, latch it up, and you're ready to go. Now, my personal trombone is shaped a little different than yours, so I'm going to use this trombone to show you how to hold the instrument. I don't have a mouthpiece on this particular one. I'm not going to play it. I'm just going to show you how to hold it. So if you're looking at it and you're thinking that there's something missing, yes, you are correct. There is no mouthpiece on this trombone, but it's shaped like yours, so that's why I'm going to use it. So the trombone slide is here, and we've been holding it in our right hand to pick it up. But now we're basically going to transfer it from my right hand to my left hand, because the left hand holds all the weight of the trombone. So as I transfer it over, I'm going to start with my left thumb. Go ahead and give me a thumbs up. Yeah. And you'll see this corner right here on the bell. I'm going to jam my thumb through it and kind of point it towards the mouthpiece. Then I'm going to wrap it around just like that. Then I'm going to take my other four fingers, and I'm going to find the cross beams of the slide, and I'm going to stick all four fingers inside. So it should look like this. My thumb came up through this corner right there, and then I stuck it into that square just like that. Watch again from another angle. My thumb comes through that corner, four fingers go in that square. And this is how we hold the trombone. All the weight is basically in my left hand here. And the right hand is free to operate the slide when we get to that. We're not going to do that today, but at least you know how to hold it. So, thumb right here in the corner, four fingers in that square, and I'm going to hang onto it just like this. As I bring the trombone up into plane position, I want to make sure that all that weight is in my left hand. And I'm going to hold it at basically a V. So if you think of the slide and the bell as forming a 90-degree angle, it's going to make the letter V. So don't have it into an L or a backwards L. Make sure that it forms a V. My right hand, I'm going to hold this cross beam right there as if I was holding the mouthpiece. You might remember that as we hold our mouthpiece, it's with the thumb and two fingers. I'm going to do the same thing for this. As I bring it up into plane position, I'm going to grab this second bracing right there with thumb and two fingers right there at the bottom. And I'm going to put my other fingers right below it, just like this. So my right hand position really looks like that. I grab that cross beam with thumb and two fingers, and then my other two fingers are below. Years ago, there was a TV show called Star Trek. Maybe your parents know about it. There was actually a movie a few years ago where they remade it. And one of the characters on there was an alien. His name was Spock. He was a Vulcan. And he would do this. He would say, "Live long and prosper." But I always think that Spock would have made a pretty good trombone player, because he's got his right hand already in position with two fingers on top, two fingers on bottom, thumb just like this, and he's ready to play the trombone. So maybe Spock was that alien was a trombone player. Probably not. I swapped out the other trombone for my own personal trombone, and you'll notice that mine looks a little different. I don't have a cross brace right here where I put my thumb through. Instead, I have a valve here that I can operate with my thumb. Otherwise, though, everything else is still the same. My four fingers go through that little square here on the slide. My thumb and first two fingers grab the bottom of that cross brace. My other two fingers go right below, and I use the Vulcan Live Long and Prosper hand position. As I'm doing this both for that other trombone and for this trombone, I want to make sure that my right hand is holding the trombone slide with the tips of my fingers. I want to make sure that I'm back here, not all the way in. Okay, so don't do this, do this. Are you ready to play your trombone? We're going to play that instant sound exercise where we're going to blow and we're going to create a sound, and it's basically going to sound like a jet. We're going to hold it as long as possible. Remember, we're not using our slide today. We are only just blowing a note right through the instrument. Let's give it a shot. Now, you might have noticed the way I brought my instrument up into plane position. I rotated it flat, I brought it into my face, I played, then I pulled it off my face, and I rotated it down. That's how we bring our instrument into and out of plane position. Let's try it again, And you'll notice that when as I was playing right there, I didn't use the slide at all. I played what we call an open note. It's the same on other brass instruments. If you don't operate any valves or you don't use the slide, we call that an open note. There are actually several different open notes you might get on trombone. I'm going to try again, and I'm going to get a different open note. And once again, you'll notice how I brought my instrument up and in, off, and then down. Now that note was a little bit higher. There's actually a third note we could also get as an open note that you'll commonly play this year in fifth grade. I'll play that highest of those three open notes for you now. To get plenty of air to get these high and low notes, I want to make sure I'm sitting in the edge of the chair, sitting tall, left foot flat, right foot back. That seating position really makes a big difference in how much air I can get to play the trombone. So these open notes actually have names. In music, the names for the notes are letters like A or B or C. To figure out which note is which on the trombone, we can use BandMate. So go ahead and grab a device that you've installed BandMate on, and let's try it again. And this time we'll use the BandMate app to find out exactly which note we're getting. To set up BandMate, I'm going to select trombone from the instrument list, and then I'm going to select on this right-hand side that switch. I'm going to use the top setting, the flat. Now, a musical flat symbol kind of looks like a pizza on a stick, or maybe half of a heart with a line through it, and that's the one we want. I don't want to select the bottom option, which is the sharp, which looks like a hashtag or a number sign. I want to keep it on the flat, which is the top one. And I'm going to go ahead and play those three different notes for you, the three different open notes. I'm going to play each one, making it long and steady and even. I don't want it to go up and down. I don't want it to stop in the middle. I want to hold each note as long as possible. You'll notice that the lowest of the three notes is going to be a note called B flat. It'll say B, but then it'll also have that little flat symbol next to it. The middle open note is called F. And the top open note is called, it's also called B flat. That's kind of weird, isn't it? Not so much. I mean, if you think of families, sometimes there'll be a family where maybe mom is named Sally and her daughter is also named Sally. Or maybe dad is named Jimmy and his son is named Jimmy as well. So, same kind of thing here. We have high B flat and low B flat. It's kind of like parent and child. And then the note in between them is called F. As you try playing these notes with BandMate, you might find that some of the notes are easier to play. There might be one note that you consistently get every time. Maybe it's a low B flat or that middle F. And then to get the others, you might need to think about your corners and your tongue position. So work each day this week on seeing if you can get at least two out of those three open notes. Maybe you'll get the F and the low B flat, or maybe you'll get the F and the high B flat. If you can get all three notes, fantastic. That's your goal for this next couple of weeks, is to be able to get at least two notes and hopefully three notes. Think about the kind of things you would need to do to get high and low jets. Do those same things on the trombone, and it'll work out just fine. As we did before, the notes are going to stay very steady and even. I'm going to hold them as long as I possibly can, filling up with lots of air by sitting correctly with sitting tall on the edge of the chair, left foot flat, right foot back. That's going to help you produce a great sound. For those higher notes, you do need to use a lot of air, so fill up with air, it's going to help. We're not going to use our slide yet. That'll be what we'll look at next week. So don't mess with the slide this time. Just make sure you're holding the instrument correctly. Make sure you're holding the slide correctly. And each day this week, I want you to work on mouthpiece buzzing first. Air to sound, then instant sound, high jets, low jets, dropping bombs. Put the instrument together, and then try doing some notes with BandMate. Try to get at least two different notes, possibly even three. So that's your goal for this week. And if you do that a little bit each day, it gets easier and easier. Until next time, go practice.